Hey bro, thanks a million. I'd love it if you could create a video tutorial on fixing dynamic linking issues between After Effects and Premiere Pro on MacBook. That would be super helpful. At Epaphrasion, you asked,
and here it is.
Stay with me.
For this studio right here,
and you're welcome to my channel.
Let's dive right in.
To begin, ensure you have installed compatible versions of Premiere Pro and After Effects. Having incompatible versions of the software is one of the most notorious causes of dynamic linking issues between After Effects and Premiere Pro. Once that is checked, the next point to note is ensure that your After Effects project is saved in a known location. Once After Effects is open, you can flick back to Premiere Pro to see the linked After Effects project. Right-click to reveal project location. It is essential to know that the After Effects COM, although this is on the timeline, is linked to a file somewhere. That project file has to be read by dynamic link for you to see it on your timeline. If you delete the file or location is changed or moved or remained, you have broken the dynamic link. In the event that the link is broken, go to Premiere Pro project panel, right-click and select Make it offline, then it goes offline. Right-click again and select Link Media. Follow through to the project location, select the After Effects project file, and that should work. But if that doesn't work, your next option would be to re-import. So you can just make this offline, leave it where it is, then re-import. Alt-click and drag and replace the one that is broken on the timeline. Moving on, what if you right-click to choose the option of replace with After Effects composition and is grayed out at your end, or a connection is not established between Premiere Pro and After Effects? This is what to do to fix it. First, you need to rename the sequence properly in case you haven't. And in our case, I will be saving it with the title of this tutorial, Dynamic Link Issues Solved. Once that is done, I'll go ahead to save the Adobe Premiere Pro project with another name, just for the purpose of the tutorial, Dynamic Link PP to AE. Once that is done, flip to After Effects, go to File, scroll down to Adobe Dynamic Link, click on the drop-down arrow and select Import Premiere Pro Sequence. Once that is done, from the storage device called GRT, folder NCC, then Project. And there you find our Premiere Pro project, Dynamic Link PP to AE. Once selected, it will show our sequence, Dynamic Link Issues Solved. Select that and click OK. That is open in After Effects. Then you can drag the composition and create a new composition inside of After Effects. Then go ahead and save the After Effects project. And for the purpose of this tutorial, I will name it Dynamic Link AE to PRP. Click Save, then head back to Premiere Pro. Once in Premiere Pro, select any file on the timeline, right-click and select Replace with After Effects Composition. A dynamic link will be created. As a result, it is open in After Effects. And as you can see, this file takes on the name of our Premiere Pro project, Dynamic Link PP to AE, and our After Effects project, Dynamic Link AE to PRP. Hence, a link has been created. So whatever changes you make in After Effects will be reflected in Premiere Pro. And I'll just do some to show you. Add a solid color behind and click back to Premiere Pro to see it reflect. I'll even go ahead to type a text, Dynamic Link Issues Solved. And you flick back to Premiere Pro and see it reflected.
And voila, there you have it.
Dynamic Link Issues Solved.
If this video has been helpful, do let us know in the comment section.
Give us a thumbs up to help with the algorithm
and subscribe to get our future post notification.
Bye for now.